Good evening. As Father said in his homily, it was a great desire of mine that as I began to talk to people about leaving and different groups like the St. Vincent de Paul Society and folks at Daybreak and folks in MG Alert, the anti-trafficking group, and different say, well, how are we going to say goodbye? And I realized it could get really out of hand if all those groups wanted to say goodbye in their own way. And I realized this was a moment for me to be able to say goodbye my way. And to say that the reason I came to Macon was because my community and my God sent me here. And when we talk about interfaith work, and we talk about bringing churches and faiths and those of no faith and those of partial faith and those who aren't sure of their faith together, that no one of us ever watered down who we are, but that we bring the joy of who we are and what motivates us and what inspires us and what fills our hearts, that we bring it to the full. Clearly, this was no watered-down mass. And that was important to me. It's important to me to share with you the fullness of the faith that I have in the God that I follow, and to thank him for sending me here. St. Lawrence, some of you don't know about St. Lawrence, was challenged, I think it was by a king, you could read the story, Google St. Lawrence. He was asked to bring the treasures of the church, because everyone thinks the church is really rich, and to bring all the treasures of the church to the king. And what St. Lawrence did was he brought to the church all those who were poor and homeless, all those who were struggling and vulnerable, and said, these people, these are the treasures of the church. So tonight I have brought my treasure to the church, and that's each of you. And I've brought it to the altar of the God that I worship to give him thanks that our paths have crossed, that he chose this time and this place for me to grow up as a daughter of charity. 10 years ago, I was only 9 years a daughter of charity. Now I'm 19, went from being a middle schooler to a graduate. And I could only do that because of the gift of each of you. None of us do any of this ourselves. We can joke about canonizations and all that. None of us do any of this by ourselves. We all do it in community and in together. We do it as one family before whatever God it is that we worship. But that we do it in a way that says to each member of that community, without you, the community would be lacking. Without you, the community would be less. Without each one of us, the work can't get done. So to be thankful to God is the first place for me. It's to bring each of you the gems of this experience that I've had in Macon. To bring each of you to God and thank him with the fullest of hearts that I can. I've said to my friend June Bryant, I spend a lot of time in Little Rock saying, where is my June Bryant in Little Rock? Where is my Kay Gerhardt? Where are my new pastors? Where are the new, all of the people that I've met here, where are they in Little Rock? And they're there. I know God will gift me there as much as here. And I can only hope that I can be of service there as much as I have tried to be here. But I also need to give thanks to, obviously, each of you, to each of the groups that have come together to serve those who are vulnerable, to serve those who live in poverty, to thank all those who let their vulnerabilities be known and have allowed me and those who have helped me and have helped each of us to be better people. Some of us are housed now that weren't before. Some of us are working now that weren't before. Some of us are more aware of the struggles that others had than we weren't before. All of that is God's gift. I want to thank everyone on the altar here and each person who's helped with this Mass to make it a joyful celebration. Some of you who aren't Catholic might not get all of it, you know, the smells, the bells, the whistles, but it means an enormous amount to me. And so I'm grateful, and especially grateful to our bishop who came, and to the priests and deacons and servers, and I'd like to say to each of the young people here, this is an amazing church that we belong to. And as you grow up into it, you'll see that we might look old and seem old, but we're pretty powerful folks. And we're so grateful that each of you are here helping us to worship and helping us to thank our God for all that he gives us. But lastly, I would like to especially thank my sisters. I can't do anything without them. They are the ones I go home to every night. And they are the ones who have to put up with me every night. They are the ones who have to hear the crazy stories of what happened during the day. They're the ones who help put me in my place when I need to be put there. They're the ones who help to challenge me when I get slacking. They're the ones who can help push me out the door. They're the ones who remind me of how I have to take care of myself when I'm sick. They are the greatest gift that God has given me. My community and my sisters have helped me to find my fullest self, and I am so grateful to each of you, and grateful that you've been here and that you support me, as I say, even in the times when it's difficult to be supportive. So I go to Little Rock with each of you in my heart, praying to God that I find replications of each of you there, hoping that Little Rock will be an experience much like Macon, and remembering always that Macon is the mother church, that Macon is, and Daybreak and DePaul USA and all of our groups are the beginnings, and I bring all of that with me. I just want to thank each of you and know that you will be in my constant prayers. I just want to say one last thing to Father McDonald especially. He ordered me to stay. No offense, Father, but I don't take orders from you. But I know that we both take orders from the one who is so much greater than us. And both he and I and all those of us who have fulfilled our vocations, and each of us has a vocation, we believe that we are following the orders of our God. And it is God who sends me forth as a daughter of charity, as a Catholic woman, as a woman open to serving those who are vulnerable, and being able to serve in my own vulnerability. So, with all of that, we're going to go have cupcakes. Because this is also a celebration of all that we have been together. And cupcakes just happen to be one of my favorite things, and it's not often you get to just say, we're going to have cupcakes today. So I invite you all for cupcakes and iced coffee or whatever else they decided to have, because they think not everyone's going to want that. There are three ways that you can get to the cupcakes. You can either go out the side door and down a flight of stairs off to the left. You can go out the back doors or the front doors, whatever you decide. You can go out that way and down the steps, and there's an entrance down there. Or if you want to wait a little while and possibly miss a cupcake, or if you need to, there is an elevator in the back right behind us. So there are three ways to get there. I hope that you will all join us there. And again, thank you to each and every one of you, and thank you to all of you who have helped us worship here today. Thank you so very much.